What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Drippy J, aka J Bangers, aka Goatee J, and I'm back with another banger. And today I got a story time for y'all about my first fight in middle school. My very first hand-to-hand fight with a specific person. Well, I'm not gonna mention no names, but it was just my first fight, so let's get into it. All right, so basically, so me and this dude, we were beefing about, all right, so we was at practice, and then basically, dude was talking stuff about me and my sister during practice, football practice, standing on the sidelines. We both weren't even practicing, so we was just talking to each other, you know, saying this, saying that, you know how it go whenever you just beefing with somebody or you just got a problem with somebody, you just steady talking to them like, ain't no tomorrow. You talking to them crazy like, I'm finna, you already know, so. All right, so basically, dude keeps talking and we're like both talking, you know, just talking reckless. Like, we were in eighth grade, so you know how eighth graders are, they just talk reckless. And so basically, what happened was, dude was talking, right? And all of a sudden, he just started talking too crazy. And he brought up my sister. My sister, you know? So, you know, I'm over there like, what you say? And he was like, blah, 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 about your sister. I'm like, oh, so you really just, all right. So, mind you, practice wasn't over yet. So, we had a few more minutes of practice. So, then I was like, all right, I got you in the locker room. We gonna see in the locker room. So basically, we walk, practice done, you know, everybody, you know, hop, we going to the coach talking to us, you know, I'm ready. I'm like, okay, dude, just talking something about my sister. So you already know we got a pasta. But no, he's talking stuff about my sister. I was like, all right, you ain't going to get away with that. I don't care. You was not going to. So then basically, we running up the field, you know. As we go up to the locker room, I'm telling him that I'm going to come up to you and we going to have to talk. And, you know, he's just like, oh, whatever, you know, blah, blah, this, blah, blah, that. And I'm like, okay, bet. He don't think I'm for real. Basically, we walk up to the locker room. Everybody's getting their pads, shoulder pads off. Everybody's getting undressed. It's after school, you know, everybody's tired. They trying to go home. So, basically, I take off myself, right? And I don't know if he forgot, but I was like, where do you think you're going? Like, I literally walked up to him. I said, bro. Did you forget what you said to me about my sister? So then I said, all right, so what was that you were saying on the field at practice? And he was just standing there. He didn't even deserve a punch. He deserved a smack. Smacked him right in his face. Then all of a sudden we just start throwing hands. Like it wasn't even fist, but like he was just like, I don't know. It really wasn't like. We just started, I don't know why, we just started, like, slap each other. It's weird, like, fights don't usually go that way, but I'm like, he just started spanking, so I'm like, I'm, like, literally, he's charging at me. And usually when someone charges at you, like, you usually, like, you charge at them back, but I don't know what I was doing. You know, this is my first fight, so adrenaline rush, you know everything. You know, your first fight, you know, it's like, oh, I don't know what to do. So it's like, is it you ready or not? So I guess that day I wasn't ready. So basically, dude rushing at me, just throwing barrages and slaps. I'm over here trying to counter him, like, ooh, I got that, and, you know, backing me up to the restroom until two dudes came and got him and held him back. And they was like, oh, what's the issue? Like, they was just all like, you know. So then after that happened, I got dressed like nothing happened. Like, I just, but like, I did what I had to do. Like, simple. So dude over there, he just, you know, sitting right there, I walk right past him towards Dory. Didn't say nothing, untouched. Just walk straight past him. Didn't say nothing. And then people were like, oh, why'd you afraid? And I just told him, I was like, dude was talking stuff about my sister. So then basically, a couple days passed. The same dude that I had problems with in our fight, you know, after all that, I thought things were done, you know? So basically, next day, it's in the morning, you know, and in the morning, usually nothing happens at school in the morning. Like, it's like, what, 7 something? Like, who wants to fight? Or, like, you know. So basically, dude, he has a problem with another kid. I'm not gonna say his name, but the other kid, he didn't even do nothing. We was just all walking because we was all like in a gymnasium, the gym where you know where you stay and sit. So basically, everybody's getting released. We get released last because we were eighth graders. We're walking in the hallway. Dude literally starts screaming. He starts pointing, but he wasn't pointing at me. I was like, that's why I got confused. I was like, so why you, like, he was pointing at the dude, the other dude. So then he started screaming and stuff and all this and that. I was like, oh, shoot, like, what happened between them, you know? I was like, dang, this dude got beef with everybody nowadays, you know? So, and basically, I go to first period, you know? I have first period algebra. So I'm going to first period, you know, I think it's going to be a regular day, you know, it's just another day, like, I wasn't even thinking about what happened yesterday, I was just like, it's another regular day, like, school, like, I'm coming to school to learn, you know. Then, basically, I think she was I don't know what she was, she came and, you know how, like, you in trouble, but you try to, like, you know, like, so basically, she was like, oh, come with me. I'm like, somebody told. So now I'm like, dang, like, and it was like in front of everybody. So you know how you feel whenever you get called and like you literally had to walk by one of those type of feelings. Like it felt like it was. So then basically she take me to the office. I'm sitting in a chair thinking like, oh, God, I'm finna get ISS. Someone then told I'm finna get in trouble. It's done. They finna call my mom. My mom finna whoop. Well, no. But then, all right, so they end up just talking about some. So they brought up they had found out because someone, I don't know how they found out, but they found out. So basically, they were talking about how, oh, I need to write, you know, whenever you get in trouble, you need to write, like, why you did this and what happened. So basically, I did that. And then after I wrote that, they take me to this room. There was this big guy. He used to be, like, the lookover of people who got in trouble in ISS. So, basically, I didn't know I was going to go to ISS that day. So, I was like, because I literally thought it was going to be a normal day. So, then I end up going to ISS. And the other dude that didn't even do anything, he ended up going to ISS, too. So, and the dude that I fought, we all ended up going to ISS. So, we were in ISS for, like, what? 3 days straight. It felt like prison. We literally had to go straight to the room and we couldn't go nowhere else. The only place we can go is the restroom. It's like, you know how you get grounded at, like, yeah, you know how you get grounded at the house and you can't go nowhere and you be like trying to sneak into that restroom. Boy, it wasn't even sneaking, but you know, like you can only go to a restroom. Like whenever you're grounded, you can only do certain stuff. So that's how I felt groundation at school, which sucks. Like, we were literally in a room. No noise or nothing. You could have farted, and everybody in there would have heard it, smelt it. Like, they would have known you dealt it. So then, I'm just thinking, like, wow, like, I'm really in ISS. Mind you, this is my first time ever in ISS. I literally, that was literally my first time ever in ISS. I was like, dang, like, I don't even know why I'm here. I had a good validation of what I did. I feel like I was right. The situation, I just feel like you need to get in trouble. And then it was like, we were in there for 3 days, you know, and then after those 3 days, we just went back to normal class and everything. But it was like, the whole experience was just like, it was just crazy. It was literally like, and then while I was in ISS, I was literally sneaking on my phone I literally had to do like this and get on my phone like that during ISS and nobody even knew. It was like I was hacking the system. Like, oh, y'all think because I, no. I'm doing that. So then basically after we got ISS, you know, we doing our time, you know, we just did our 3 days, you know, football practice continues as normal. You know, once you get in trouble, you know you were in trouble with the coach. So, you know, the coach, he addressed it, you know, after normal practice, you know. Someone on the football team gets in trouble, your whole team is going to be running. You're going to be running no matter what you're running for, you know. So, long story short, coach made us run the whole field about, what, fourth times, you know, and he was just giving a speech about how, you know, we shouldn't be fighting, and then, like, you know, this, like, you know, all the coaching stuff they say to you. And then, basically, everybody on the team was getting mad at us. But I was like, the whole time, I was like, I did what I had to do. You can't get mad. Like, I'm going to run these with y'all, but just because you're mad at me don't mean that's going to change how I feel about what I did. So, it was like, after we ran those, I was like, whatever. And then after that, it was just crazy. So, yeah, that's my story time on how I got in my first fight in middle school, eighth grade. Mind you, I was in eighth grade. And it was a learning experience, you know, like, it was a learning experience. But do I regret it? I honestly say no. I honestly should have did worse. You know why? Because, well, actually, I take it back. I don't regret anything I did, you know, so, yeah. But the whole ISIS, if I would have known, I would have never did it. But, yeah, this is my story time on how I got in my first fight in eighth grade. I hope y'all enjoy this. Leave a like, leave a sub, leave a comment. Press the notification bell if you want to be notified about any other videos I'm doing. And if you are a new subscriber to the Drippy Gang, leave a comment on what you want me to tell you about or any video ideas that you want me to do. But until then, y'all have a drippy day. I'm gonna catch y'all later. Peace.